Borland's teachings by Dr. M.L. Tyler. Dr. Borland has evolved his own way of discovering the remedy, the comparative way. He groups his drugs and then in each case works through the selected group till he has found the one that fits. And from his abundant practical experience, he can speak with precision and authority. But some of our newer recruits, lacking his great knowledge of materia medica, find prescribing for children rather alarming. And yet children's work has always seemed about the easiest one has had to tackle, provided one concentrates upon some few characteristics which lie so close to the surface in children as to be difficult to miss. 1. Fears, terrors and suspicions. Fears of strangers, of thunder, of the dark, of being alone, of noise, even sensitiveness to small noises. One cannot forget a wee boy of some 5 years who, during the dinner hour in our children's ward, was wailing. The children make such a noise. His poor little nerves were jarred by the click of spoons on plates. And this so alien to what one expects in a small child would be symptom that must be taken into account in prescribing for the eruption on his swollen and disfigured little face. 2. Food cravings and aversions. The resistless desire for salt, for sweets, for fats, or the reverse, the unconquerable loathings. Why a mere baby will open his round mouth and promptly eject anything too sweet, too warm, or too cold to its taste, or tighten its lips obstinately against the same milk. But one remembers always that change in any characteristic during or due to illness is of the greatest importance in prescribing. 3. Then the all-important mentalities, and children are happily not adepts in hiding these. There is a little maiden out to please, to claim sympathy, to charm, and the child that draws back into its shell, unconsolable and resentful of advances and approach. The extremes here being pulsatilla on the one hand and CP or netramure on the other. Shyness one cannot miss, or the restless, anxious, suspicious, arsenic-like child, or again, in sharp contrast, the calcarea, heavy dullness, mental and physical. One learns to group these, ringing the changes as one symptom or another comes into prominence or recedes. The slender, anxious child in terror of the dark who steals salt cannot be alone and suspicious demands phosphorus. The else, sepia child, but with brown eyes and the cravings for salt and fat, which throw sepia out of consideration, will need nitric acid. It will cure even her obstinate constipation. Or this one again, craving salt, but loathing fat and meat, and fearing thunder, is asking for netramure. Or craving salt with loathing of fat and meat, and in terror of thunder, suggest carbo veg. But a craving for sweets with fears in the dark, when alone, and of thunder, puts up a plea of lycopodium, especially if the mental development exceeds the physical, and the idea of facing anything unusual excites distress. Then the little fairy who loathes fats and meat, who is afraid alone and in the dark, with perhaps suspicion and jealousy thrown in, is the tender-hearted VP pulsatilla, and on the other hand, the passionate, spiteful little creature, also suspicious and jealous, who perhaps craves fats and dislike meats, is asking for nux. One finds in children's work a delightful field for exercise of added powers that homeopathy bestows on those who seek her paths of pleasantness and healing and peace.